show's gonna start in just a minute. And, I gotta go powder my nose.
Why, Sherry, you're not gonna do your show tonight.
I ain't?
No, of course not. You gotta go pack your suitcase.
Oh, it's all right, Pat. I mean, I gotta go powder my nose.
Sherry, what's the matter with you? Are you sick or something?
No, I ain't sick, Ma. I just can't lie to you. And I can't marry you, and I ain't going to Montana with you. And goodbye forever.
Sherry, wait a sec. Sherry, wait a sec. Sherry!
Los Angeles bus leaving from gate 2.
Yeah, Bo.
Loading right away.
Wait a minute, Bo. Help me unload this stuff. Yeah, Bo. Forget it, Bo. You find somebody else. Hank and Orville was telling me about this new school, Mom. They're staying over.
I don't want no school, Mom. I want Cherry.
Los Angeles bus leaving from gate
2. Cherry!
Bo! You just can't take people places like that. There's laws against it, Bo.
That's way. Right ahead.
Crazy, what do you think you're doing?
Anything I ever wanted in this life, I just went out and got.
But Marilyn could do justice to Bus Stop, the smash hit that had Broadway howling for more and more, with Arthur O'Connell, Betty Field, and Hope Lang as her traveling companions. And just look at the guy who ropes Marilyn, introducing Hollywood's newest hunk of man, Don Murray. He didn't want her to know that when it came to women, he knew nothing but nothing. She didn't want him to know that when it came to men, she knew plenty, but plenty.
Of course, it's only what you might call a physical attraction.
Physical?
I mean, you're so big and strong and, well, so darn healthy looking.
Yes, I do keep myself in pretty good shape. Of course, you got it when you're competing in a rodeo like that, all class A, I mean.
You got this idea that a woman is like some animal you're trying to break.
That's right.
But there are some gals who don't like to be pushed and grabbed and lassoed and drugged into buses in the middle of the night.
He could ride like a fury, throw steers like a fiend, do push-ups like a champion. But when it comes to taming this filly, he really has a bronco by the tail.
Thank you. The film is running in the camera. Marilyn acts. You cannot get her to stop it. Even if she would forget a line, which occasionally she did, not because she didn't know it, but because she was so critical of herself that she would hate the way she'd read the last line and begin thinking about that instead of reading the line that was supposed to be said. Joe Curtis, my assistant, would read her the line. We coached him to throw the line at her. She kept acting all through the coaching so that you didn't feel that she was listening to a prompt. It was really quite remarkable. There's several pauses like that in Bus Stop if you look carefully.
I don't know why I keep expecting myself to fall in love, but I do.
Well, I know I expect to someday.
I'm seriously beginning to wonder if there's a kind of love I have in mind.
What's that?
I don't know. Well, you see, I've been going with guys since I was about 12.
Honest?
Honey, I almost married a cousin of mine when I was 14. But Pappy wouldn't have it.
I never heard of anyone married so young.
Down the Ozarks, we don't waste much time. I sure am glad, though, I never married my cousin Malcolm. Because he turned out real bad. Just like Pappy predicted. But I sure was crazy about him at the time. And I've been losing my head about some guy ever since. Beau was the first one that ever wanted to marry me. Since my cousin Malcolm. Naturally, I'd like to get married and have a family and all them things.
But you've never been in love?
I don't know. Maybe I have and I didn't know it. That's what I mean. Maybe I don't know what love is.
I think she is one of the most extraordinary actresses that ever lived. I think she is a combination of Greta Garbo and Charlie Chaplin. Because she has that wonderful comedy, that pitiful, sweet kind of sorry for, where you feel sorry for her and laugh at the same time that Chaplin has. And she has the fabulous, ephemeral beauty of Garbo.